This video is brought to you by Mjengo Tracker.
Well, in the middle of struggling, yeah. You're like a blind man in a dark room trying to find your way around. So here kuna kitu important here for a business person. Mahali unaweza show up asubuhi organize.
Yeah.
And said ha, now customers will come. I mean business. Shock on you. From saying, now you're in business to customer number one, man, it'll take 6 months.
Man, you work for the week,
and you work looking for customers kwa site.
Urenda
ukiimba Mungu wangu. We waju wa sababu. Kwa nini? You really suffer, for real.
Keeping records is hard. Trust me, I like keeping records. You guys know I like keeping records. I use spreadsheets or just a normal notebook like this, and you can see all the records I keep here. They are quite, they are not very tidy records. I'm introducing something that will say goodbye to the hassle. And that is Mjengo Tracker. So this is the ultimate construction tracker that revolutionizes project management. With Mjengo Tracker, every construction detail is at your fingertips. Track the progress, monitor its spaces, and coordinate tasks all in one place. No more wasted time on spreadsheets and address paperwork. No more guesswork, guys. Stay ahead of the game with real-time updates and seamless collaborations. Whether on site or on the go, Mjengo Tracker keeps you in control. Join the construction revolution and visit mjengotracker.com or download the app on the Google Play Store and take charge of your project. Hi guys, so as you can see, I'm in BioTank Biodigester. This is in Thika, and these guys, I came to find them as I was perusing around the internet, finding on how to build a biodigester, and somehow I came across this, and I visited them during the week.
Stella.
They taught me about the biodigester, and I say I realized that the owner of this premise is a friend, someone collective. Who we have crossed paths in 2014-2015, and his name is Edwin.
Come
here. So to repatana naye, and I was amazed that he is the proprietor of this great invention here. And you staki kuongea juu ya the invention, just want you to speak for yourself, and you can just give us a rundown of who Edwin is, who BioTank Africa, what are you? BioTank what?
BioTank Africa.
Yeah, BioTank, yes, Africa, yes. Is, yeah, just give us a rundown of what is this.
Thank you, Willy. So my name is Edwin Cheruo.
Okay.
I work here at BioTank Africa. Basically, we are sanitation contractors. At least that was the first thing that we started with before everything else could take shape. Willy, we must be very grateful today because we found time to come to Sembelea, Uku, Juakali, Mashinani. We are very happy.
Okay.
So
this is not the first time, second time I came on Nini. You remember?
Oh yes.
We can do a video.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We are happy that you've been very consistent on this.
Yeah.
So karibu leo nitakutake through how this system works, and how we came about to get here to this point.
Okay. So all these are biodigesters.
Yeah, all these are biodigesters for domestic use. For domestic use, because you see, wastewater really tunayangaliaga from the perspective of number of users.
Okay.
So users wa nyumba commercial to bedroom kumi, ni wase kama 50.
Yeah.
You give each unit 5 users.
Yeah.
That's a different set of users from your family, which is probably 3 or 4 people.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. So this particularly is for domestic
use. Okay.
And most of our families are usually the same.
Yeah.
Either have 4 kids. If you're very courageous with this economy, you go to 6. You should be given an award. For courage.
Kabisa.
So Here we are.
Yeah.
We have a...
And this is your invention, by the way?
Yes.
In invention, Niako.
I'll take you to our first prototype that we did back in 2019.
Okay.
Using fiberglass.
Yeah.
With a lot of confusion on whether this thing will work or not.
Okay.
This is what happened, Miano.
Okay.
When I decided to get into the sanitation business.
Okay.
And registered Biotank Africa. It was out of need. So we were putting up family home here too.
Mm-hmm.
The house was almost finished.
Okay.
Painted, tiled, at a toilet seat were in place.
Okay.
But we did not have a septic tank. And back in the day, I used to be in corporate. So sikuwa na information mingi ya how Juakali works, how Mjengo works. So I asked my foreman, casually, septic tank itakuwa dongapi. And I wanted to move in quickly. So the guy tells me casually, septic tank itakost 140K. Na niteketeke. So nikamwambia, sina do. Why don't you go back, ufanye hesabu. Then tomorrow bring me an itemized list.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So the guy goes back and comes back the following day with an itemized list. Simiti, how many bags, chuma. In fact, he came with someone to do excavation.
Okay.
And excavation alone was going to cost 40,000. Just kuchimba shimo. It was actually 45,000. Juu place yangu iko na marab.
Yeah, yeah.
So now I'm confused. From 140 to 285.
Wow.
And I don't have money. So now I'm calling neighbors. Umeka nini kwako? Na umeka nini? And I'm stuck. And nasikuwa na ile choya shimo yenye waso na ikaga site.
Yeah.
Misikuwa na wasijui mafundo likuwa naenda wapi. I think nyasi ili benefit your season. Your season bushes ili benefit.
Achani kaisa ina kitu enene. That's funny. Yeah.
Yeah, so manze, juka ningekone yo pitlatrin, ninge drainio mazi yote.
Kwa hapo.
Yeah. Alafu niseme enda jipanga.
Pole, yeah.
But that didn't happen. So now I'm calling neighbors asking, uko na nini na wewe. And I remember the hardware used to buy materials. Kulikuwa na banner.
Yeah.
Banner ma poster.
Yeah.
Poster ime choro biodigester.
Yeah.
Na iko na telephone numbers hapo.
Okay.
So we went there with the boss lady, my wife. Eh? And we were calling those numbers, myself, her, and the hardware owner. None went through. So we got stuck again. Long story short, after like 3 to 4 weeks, we found someone to do a biodigester. So he came home, akajenga, and all works, materials, labor, everything, baka technology transfer, ilikam 92K.
92?
Imagine,
yeah.
From 285 to 92K.
Yeah.
Said, what? But now this is the thing. While he was doing it, I fell in love with the tank. I looked at the biodigester and I had it call my name. And I don't know who falls in love with a septic tank.
No.
It must have been the voice of God.
Yeah.
It must have been the voice of God speaking to me.
Yeah.
And so from that day, I decided I'm going to ditch my 8 to 5, Mr. A job, and I'll be doing this job. The other thing I noted as we were building, I realized, Nivo, I think I could have done it better with not training prior.
Mm.
So I decided to stop working where I was working and start doing this. And more so because I had suffered for almost a month, bila msewa kujenga. So I said I'll be the available guy. So I went, registered the company. No, the business name at that time.
Yeah.
And said, now customers will come. I'm in business. Shock on you. From saying, now you're in business to customer number one, man, it'll take 6 months.
In
6 months.
Naelewa biashara.
With
biashara.
Young children to feed.
Yeah.
A young beautiful wife. Hey, bro. Three, four, tough.
6 months na kama umetoka every month unapata kitu.
Hey.
I understand that. I can nakumbuka naelewa. Yeah, naelewa. I najieka kwa viatu zako hata mimi kwa hizo once in a while.
And then you know even the first customer, you know, make margin big.
Yeah.
una survive.
Yeah.
The bread crumbs.
Yeah.
5K yapa. So ni hustle hard. Then the second customer came in after 3 months.
Okay.
And the third customer. So now that's 9 months with two customers. You need a point, una feel, what am I even doing? Umetoka point ya wase kusema yule msi alichizi. Sasa hata umekubali yenyewe nilichizi. Hata ume accept situation. Bro. Usha kubali. Lazima tuzi. But now, you've been in it for so long. There is no way you're quitting. There is even nowhere to go.
Yeah.
You know, there is nowhere to go.
Yeah.
There is nothing you can do. So just keep showing up because now you're so used to showing up.
Yeah.
It's now a ritual.
Yeah.
Just show up. With your foolishness every other day. So, towards the end of that year, that is 2018, we found our third customer. By the grace of God, it happened to be an estate in Ruiru.
Yeah.
A gated estate with a 15 one-bedroom, or rather, a 4-bedroom mansion.
Okay.
Standalone units, really beautiful
15
houses.
15 houses
standalone
that
have been done for sale.
Okay.
And the developer was coming from a different contractor for sanitation.
Okay.
Because apparently the previous project, the project was smelly.
Okay.
Zilikuwa azijengwa poa. So they were looking for someone new.
Okay.
And they were coming from the oldest name in the bioseptic space.
Yeah.
And here I am as a startup. Yeah? I'm competing with the most established company.
Yeah.
Then we won. Ha! Huh? And this contract was total about 1.3 million,
oh,
if I remember correctly.
Yeah.
Now, I've stayed like almost 10 months plus with two customers only. Umaskini ime... ime kidiri, bro. Uko Brock baka. Brock is your middle name. Like the ending, Brock Keruho. Two Brock, your
home. Sasa, gani uliko unafuwa rama uniuza juu. When I knew...
Gani itoke hapi. Ayayaya, uko na jokes, bro.
Hata ulikuwa gari hiyo time, eh?
Ilikuwa ilienda zamani, umekuwa kwa Madhiri, ukashuka, ukakunya tuk-tuk, za uko kwa Nduthi, bro. Ngori, ngori.
Inama. Biashara is not for the week.
Man,
business
work,
is not for the week,
as you walk looking for customers kwa site,
unaenda
ukiimba Mungu wangu. We, waju wa sababu. Kwa nini? You really suffer for real, and that's what most guys fear.
Yeah,
your shift here from corporate to entrepreneurship, juakali if you like, it's not easy. That's what most people fear.
Yeah,
because most people expect an easy shift. Ni kama Thika Road una change lanes. Yeah, smooth. Una indicate. Yeah.
Lakini lazima upate maram na mafu na manini hapo mbele.
Actually, unaingia kwa ditch. Bro, unaingia kwa ditch.
Then
you rushing to what happened?
Yeah,
I thought I had seven, so, seven gani.
Yeah. Bro. So now this is, I know this is your first nini. Ndio uliwekea your first prototype. Ama ulikuwa unajenga zile za mawe.
That time we used to do concrete, reinforced concrete. Zile za koroga.
Yeah, naziona.
So those are the ones we were doing. Hata kwa your estate hizo ndizo nilijenga.
Okay.
And sasa unatiki, I've only done two projects.
Yeah, okay.
And here I have an estate. And like I've told you, it was slightly above 1.3 million.
Okay.
And I have kidogo experience. I don't even have structural designs that the tanks I'm building. I'm as juakali and raw as they come.
Okay.
So a few days I'm kicked out of sight. I'm not even able to execute the contract because at this time I sina fare to kadhika kwenda Ruiru. 50 bob. Sina. So, and you know how startup contractors work, unaambia client wako walipe deposit, then unaanza job na hiyo depo, then along the way unaweza mconvincingi aendelee kukupea kakitu. So you actually work with their money,
not your money.
But here this corporate client, huyu developer alisema ashawa inyoroshwa aezi ekelea mini jenge, hizi ni nyanganya, amejenga esto mingi, atanilipa.
Ah,
nikakuwa stuck. So one day, God akanipea wisdom. We were able to negotiate. That's why the Bible says a good name is better than money. It's better than gold.
Yeah.
We were able to negotiate with the hardware suppliers. Tukamwagiwa material. A good portion ya kufanya hiyo project. Na nikawambia hii ni kampuni, hata nyisi mnaona ni estate. Awa walipagi instant, ni kama tender. So, nikajitetea. I was able to talk my way around it.
Okay.
Material ikamwagwa site,
yeah.
And we were able to show up and do the project. But this is the thing, and this is why I'm giving you that story.
Yeah.
While doing that project, you see it's now 15 houses.
Yeah.
It took us about almost a month to finish.
Okay? Yeah, yeah.
Because excavation was a bit of work.
Yeah, okay.
It's while doing that job that I started asking myself, what if we had a ready-made system?
Oh.
Yes. Tunge kam, tuchimbe mashimo, iki to plug and play. Pa! Within 2 or 3 days, done. And
no, nenda.
So I was asking my mentors and the engineers who are on the ground, have you ever thought about a septic system, biodigester, that is plastic-made? And everyone was dismissing me, especially from the background I was coming from. I was coming from a finance background to Mjengo. So guys were saying, wasewa masuti na tai, mnakoka na maidia, aziwezi.
Yeah, aziwezi.
So we discussed it and I was dismissed, but I said, I feel in my heart the future is plastic. But you guys have more experience. You probably know these things more than I do, but I have a feeling that's where we are headed. So that was in 2018. Now 2019, the business grew. So well, in the first year we had 3 customers. In the following year we had 45.
That's awesome.
That is a serious improvement.
Yeah, that's
So as
2 customers
that,
per month. No, 3 customers per month.
It was almost 4.
Yeah.
45 is almost 4.
Yeah, almost 4. 3 and a half.
Which was good. It was a big shift. Now I had a lot of confidence after executing a 1. Something contract with no money.
Yeah.
Surely I had a lot of confidence now.
You have to.
So, now I had an office. I could afford the office space. And we're working as consultants here in Vika.
Yeah.
Part of the team I was working with, I hired an environmental biologist to come in with the aspect of the biology of shit. Yeah. How shit works, how it's decomposed, how enzymes work, etc. So he came in and we're also doing consultancy. This is environmental impact, environmental audit. And since I'm not a professional in that area, we needed someone. Yeah. Now, with this professional, together with my Mjengo background, now at this time I have a Mjengo background, and with his biology, we were able to design this.
And this is the first prototype now.
Yeah, this is the first prototype. So this biologist taught me that if water moves in a zigzag manner, has a higher chance of better purity.
Yeah.
So this prototype was done using fiberglass.
Okay.
And water comes in, was supposed to come in through this pipe.
Yeah.
And this is chamber one.
Yeah.
It drains from this end.
Yeah.
So there's another outlet here for this chamber, which is a stabilization chamber.
Yeah.
And then we have chamber two, which is a sedimentation chamber. It has 2 sedimentation chambers.
Okay.
So the water again drains from there to here.
Yeah.
So there's another pipe in here.
Yeah.
And luckily you can see it now.
Yeah.
And then it comes and drains, the outlet is right here.
Oh,
and that's when you compare the levels. Mm-hmm. This one is a few inches below.
Exactly. By the way, let me give you a small background. The reason why I contacted you is because at the moment, mimi sasa ndo najenga. Na niko na shimo tayari.
Nice!
Shimo yangu iko. And the idea, even I pronounced it to my subscribers, I'm going to build my own biodigester because I saw it being built in my previous project.
Oh.
Na nikaisoma. I'm very technical. Napenda kuwa very technical. Nikasema, you know what? Nitaenda, amejenga. By the way, what you have is exactly what he did. Yake. Lakini yake si ile ya koroga.
Okay.
Yake ni anakuja mnamnunulia materials zake kwa site, you pay him labor, anakujengea.
Oh, okay.
And the total cost, it was a 2 meter cubic.
Okay.
Total cost ilingianga ni ya proti, ilingianga about 80K hapo.
Ah.
So nikajiuliza, sina hii kazi, nilimulipa almost 40K labor. Hii kazi sinaweza jifanyia.
It's true.
Si kazi naweza jifanyia.
It's true.
So, and then, nimeona, haku wamekosea because it's good. It's functioning well. It has been there for 2 years and it's okay. Iko sawa sahi.
Ah, that's nice.
Yeah. It's but true. It's the, hii venye imejengwa.
Same thing,
it's the, na hiyo ndo ilinifunza na nikafanya research. There are many others nimeona zile za round. Yako sasa, it's quite, yenye iko hapa, it's quite, but this, hii yenye umenionyesha, it's exactly. Yeah, exactly hiyo yanke.
Iko poa, but now, hii ilikuwa fiberglass. Na fiberglass si strong structurally.
Yeah.
Si agile. So tuliweka maji actually. Just to see what will happen.
Yeah.
Ikabust. Kuna place ili bust.
Hapa.
Umeiona?
Hapa hivi.
Tuliweka maji.
Niulize hapa hivi.
Ikabust. Haiwezi hold weight juu maji ni mzito.
Yeah. Got you.
So nikaanza kujiuliza sasa nimeingia hii hustle juzi, sina chapa za kufanya hii kitu, but I was happy that we have the idea. There is a prototype.
So this is the first one.
This
guys,
first one.
Wait and see the little one sasa.
Absolutely.
Wacha tuende kwa the main site. And sahi tuko your first shop, sindio?
Yes, yes. This is the oldest shop.
Hapa ndo ulikamu. Hii barabara inaitwaje?
Mangu Road,
Indika. Yeah, so ukinaingilia pale Goingwa.
Jomoko. Tukatao, Jomoko.
Okay.
I think Jomoko ni jina ya kijaka.
So,
I think kuna mjaka alikuwa na kapo ndio kaitwa Jomoko. Alafu, hii road ni inaroka Thika, inaenda all the way mpaka flyover, ndio ende Nakuru.
Oh, yeah. Hii ndio ya Gatundu, tunaita
exactly.
Barabara ya Gatundu.
Now, this is Mangu Road,
yeah? Sawa. Now, just a question. Tunaona grasses.
Yes.
Yes, we can see evidence of biodigester here.
Yes.
Enzymes
na
dislodge. Have we asked that question?
Yes.
Naona biodigester ziko, hata huku inje. But now, tunaona grasses. How comes bado ama ni juu ni mjengo bado you know sometimes it's good to know at least educate watu kibiashara.
No, what happens vile ni make sure after kutoka corporate na uko in the middle of struggling, you're like a blind man in a dark room trying to find your way around, so you have no idea where you're going, and you don't even have your walking stick, so you're totally lost. And you're staying for so long, like the first 6 months bila customer.
Yeah.
It so happens that I have relatives who do glass, building glass.
Okay.
Yeah. So akaniambia mtu wangu utakufa njaa bana. Come to kutich, kushow mambo. So nikaenda, my mom sells glass, my bro sells glass, so basically everyone in the family sells glass. Yeah. So when wakani teach how glass works, and where I come from we say roligiro tagereria mokwa, that is to say you drama work with kidogo yenye inapatikana, is it for bigger things.
So
that's what we did. Nikaenda wakani teach glass, it took a bit of time, the glass iko na tumehesabu yake, and then I started selling from their shop. So I'd get a customer and then I would call, hey bro, kuna he has wap. They would come and do it, and I would get a bit of survival money. That's how I survived the first 1 year when there was nothing for bio. Because sometimes in business you find what you actually want to do is not picking. But your heart is in it, so you're not giving up. So you find another hustle that can support. Maybe you get employment, kidogo that will not take away all the time. You find something else to support you as you continue holding on your dream.
Yeah.
So that's what I did. I did glass and we got sites up and up. And that's how this shop came to be. Like a few months later. So it said, instead of kuendeaga kio huko kwa shop zao, River Road, and I'm in Thika, why not have a shop here?
And it makes sense that unaenda kwa mijengo kutafuta kazi, bado unauza kitu ya mije,
Absolutely.
Yeah, makes sense. So you only could pivot inside the same industry.
Exactly.
It's not far-fetched and it's good. But we maintain and it is still paid. Unaweza pata ndo inalipa bills za e-shop. As you said, you're very digestible.
Hey, hii inalipa bills za hapa. Na pia kuna kitu important pia for a business person. Mahali unaweza show hapa asubuhi jiorganize.
Yeah.
So, simono uko nyuma kuna ka ofisi kadogo.
Yeah.
5 feet by less than 3 feet.
Yeah.
Place unaweza kaa, ujulize naenda hii, direction ama naenda hii. Life inanipelekaje, ujichapeka analysis. Ni important.
Yeah.
Unatoka kwa hao, psychological wajiambia nimeenda job.
Yeah.
Sasa hii ndio job. Na kama unafungua, at least unaweza kureason out.
Yeah,
leo
yeah.
kutaendaje.
Yeah,
so that's how we came about to be here.
Yeah.
And now this shop is, 6 years old, yes, it's 6 years old.
Yeah,
so it's the oldest shop.
Ah, that's awesome. So let's go to the other shop, Patrice, sasa tunaweza fanya. Uko ndio tutaenda in-depth analysis of everything by digester.
Kabisa. By the way, when we were doing the experiments in 2019, we used to buy plastic tanks.
Okay.
Tunaenda kwa factory, tunasema ikuwe hardened.
Okay.
For underground work.
Okay.
Kuna hii tank inaitagwa loft tank.
Yeah.
So we'd go and place a special order, and then it's hardened. We did the first experiment in Kitengela. I must have been September 2019. A client who had no budget for the concrete bird digester.
Okay.
So when I listened to that discussion, I said, ah, you can't afford the concrete. I'll do plastic. There's something I'm working on. It's an experiment. So I'll come do plastic. If it doesn't work, I'll do concrete for free. And the client said, game. And I was happy.
Yeah.
So we went and did it in Kite, in black cotton, in the places where people say buyers don't work. Yeah? So we did an experiment in black cotton in Kitengela in 2019, September. So to date, he's one of the happiest clients.
Oh.
Unless I call to say hi. Yeah, he doesn't have issues.
Yeah, okay.
And then the same year, we did a tax that has more than 2,000 users here in Thika, an Anglican church.
Okay.
And those ones only came to us because they had, there's a guy in Thika who does plastic bird digesters. And that time we used to optimize. This thing of chambers, we didn't have a single bio that had chambers.
Okay.
So we used to optimize and put several tanks together to create chambers so that one flows into the next and one flows to the next. It was quite a job.
Okay.
We also did a hotel in Nakuru County.
Okay.
In total, we did 7 experiments
for
plastic.
Yeah.
And I was happy that Kumbe, we can be able to work with plastic as well.
Okay.
So we shelved the whole idea and said, why don't we now look for a way of making our design a reality? Because that time we did not have our design as reality. We're just experimenting on whether plastic will also be able to hold, you know, structure.
Yeah.
So when we were satisfied that it's working, we said, sawa. Let's hold on, find a way of getting this done.
Okay.
Out of the 7 experiments, only one has failed. It's good I say that.
Yeah.
We don't have 100% performance.
Yeah.
And I don't know that you're able to guess which one failed.
Nakuru.
You know Kenyans,
Do you know why I've thought of the hotel? Because of the people put by undigestible
Absolutely,
products.
Absolutely, exactly.
And those are wet wipes. Wet wipes, kuna paper bags, you find
Wacha
them there.
Wacha kukua polite. Sama tu wasoli yaka condom, wakaika sanitary pad. Wacha kukua polite. Because that's the truth.
Yeah.
Wali kwa nanda safari rally. Vasha. Lapona flash zile vino wakaka. So your system ini blow.
Mm.
But even then it had worked for about 3.5 to 4 years.
Yeah.
Haiku bust immediately.
So atasi shida yako. Shida ni the users.
User behavior.
Yeah.
Because another big issue.
Mm-hmm.
Elephant in the room, mm-hmm. in terms of sanitation, is the user behavior.
Yeah.
Where you go on a flash, paper bags.
Yeah.
No expert system function. Whether ni bio, pit latrine, septic tank, atazakanzo, it a block.
Yeah.
There is no system in the world that is able to sustain that kind of pressure.
Yeah.
So there should be reasonable disposal of waste. Only wastewater from the toilet should come here.
Yeah.
If it's tissue paper, that's all right.
Now, msitumie wet wipes. People think wet wipes are good. They are not
Yes. Unless
it's
indicated by the manufacturer that it is degradable, it's possible to flush it in the toilet.
Yeah.
But this is in Guinea, it's almost like nylon. It's almost like kitamba fabric. It takes very long to break down.
Yeah. That's good to note that.
That's good. So long story short, we're able to look around for a manufacturer agreeable to us to produce a biodigester. So we called very many plastic molding farms in Kenya. I think at some point I was always in Athi River. There are very many in Athi River area.
Yeah.
But I don't blame them because you see, they are business people. And telling them to produce something for me, and they don't know my business plan, they don't know who will ever buy this thing.
Mm-hmm.
It was not even tested in terms of our design,
mm-hmm.
so nobody was agreeable to that.
Okay.
I think the closest we came is a manufacturer near the Kitengela Junction who told me to stop their process,
mm-hmm.
to try what I'm saying. They are going to charge, and I had done a mold. I had already done our own mold. They're going to charge us 250,000 shillings
mm-hmm.
per 30 minutes.
Per 30 minutes?
Per 30 minutes.
Per 30
it's
minutes.
Time. He's selling me factory time. Yeah. So,
so, bro, okay.
So to suspend the operations for that particular machine, ache kuproduce tanks, when you're a producer, mads, ajaribu kuproduce zangu, it was going to cost that much. So I said, ata sikuwa na ubaya, mini msawavika, ata nirudivika, tutafikiria story badaya. So we ended up looking for a manufacturer abroad.
Mm-hmm.
We went to India, look for a manufacturer, but before we could put pen to paper, we found someone who could do it better for a better price in China.
Yeah, Chinese subaru wanakuanga na nini better.
They have a customer, would you allow me to?
Yeah, come. Karibu.
Karibu ni sana. Mimi naitokea ni. Nimekujia biodigester. Tunataka
Yes.
Na maji ya choo ujigawanisha mara nne. Hapa juu kuna kuwaga na gases. Ndio kifungua manu ulunasiaga inandika. Alafu chini ya gases ni the floatables. Vitu kama fat, oil, grease, baby diaper. Kuna watu wanaweza flash vitu kaa hizo. Chitwe yezi sink. Inakuwaga hapa juu. Na hito scam. Alafu chini yake kuna maji. And then kule chini kabisa ni sludge. Hiyo ndio tunaijaga chongumu, but ndio sludge inalala huko chini. So normally, digestion wanza hapa, alafu hiyo maji inaruka na ipa hii, inakuja hii chamber ya pili. Digestion inaendelea. So hii chamber 1 inakuwaga kama 65% maji, alafu 35% hizo vitu zingine, scum, sludge na gases. Then ikikuja hapa, the same process inajirudia. But hapa, sludge ni kidogo, scum ni kidogo, jua ziezi pita, zimechungwa. So hii nakuwaga 85% maji, 15% hizo vitu zingine. Alafu inaruka na hii pipe inakuja hii side ingine. So hapa basically hakuna sludge, hakuna scum, ni kama 95 to 100% water. Alafu hiyo maji inatoka inaenda. Kwa sock pit. Sock pit.
There is
here. So, iko hivi, ndiyo muone vile inakaa ndani, but mkienda nayo kwa site mtaenda nayo ikiwa hivi. Ishashikanisho. So as you can see, imeandikwa hata inlet, taingisha tu pipe ya 4-inch waste, imetoka kwa nyumba, ingie hapa. So hii ndio chamber 1 ndio ile pale, hiyo maji itaflow tu hivyo tumeelezea pale. Ndani iko hivyo, sasa ile ni open, hii ni closed. Iende ikiflow hivyo, itoke hii pande ingine, ndio iende kwa socket. So iko that simple, ukifunga kwa pickup yako, I don't know mwana need fundi, mwana kiwa adzi.
Sasa, ile sludge iko hapa, hizo
vitu
zingine, vika hapa ni maji.
Kuchifika hapa ni maji.
Sasa, mimi ita digest hiyo vitu yote, isemekana imeisha.
Isemekana imeisha? Yes. Kuna bacteria, na pia kuna dislodging chemical. Lakini hata uziekagi hapo, unaziekaga chamber 1, ama unaziflash kwa nyumba, juu itakuja bado hapa. So hiyo ni inatapaga hiyo uchafu inakuwa maji. Na ni continuous process. So every 2 to 3 years tunafaa kuongezea chemical pale. Kwa sababu sludge inaweza kuwa ina accumulate, scum inaweza kuwa ina accumulate, upate ile maji ni kama sasa umebakisha 35% badala ile 60 tumesema so ku reduce your build up inaendelea kuongezea dawa.
Na hiyo chemical ndio hii hapa. Inaenda
kwa soft pit. So hapa kunafaa kuchimbwa shimo.
Ama zeni zote.
Achukue jamaa moja moja. Achukue anirahisishie kazi, achukue hiyo story yote mara moja, asiniulize tena. Hata yeye anaulize hizo maswali.
Nenda tu hizo chemicals waone na tofauti. Is awesome.
Ah, nice. Thank you. Ah, so tuko na these 3 types ya treatment. Hii hapa imetoka factory kwa Kasarani, inaitwa Kidawa Manufacturers. Hii ni dislodging chemical. So hii si bacteria. Hii ni dislodging chemical. Kazi yake ni the same tu na bacteria, only that hii ni ya kupiga haraka. Sijaje iko karibu haraka, inasiaga haraka, ni chemical. Na haiko affected na soap. Wajua wanasema ati umeosha na happy choo ama any other chemical, hii haiko affected. Aya, nazo hizi mbili, hizi ni enzymes, ni bacteria. So, from different manufacturers. Hii inaitwa Organica, rather imetoka company inaitwa Organica, na imetoka Osho, hapa tu Nairobi. But hii tunatoanga India. Na ni sisi kibilas wa hii. So hizi ukieka, zinajireproducing. Tofauti ya hizi na hii, hii haijireproduce. Hii na deal na hiyo chosa hii, na nguvu yake inaisha, hiyo time.
Hii
na multiply. Exactly. So hii ndio inapatia time frame kubwa. Hii unaineed at least every 2 years, but hii unaweza kaa 5 years kabla uongeze, either. So hii tuna retail 1500, hiyo tuna retail 2250, but hiyo kibaya biodigester tunapatia free kwa sababu ile agreement tumepata na wao au wenye kumanufacture hiyo. So for every purchase you get this one for free, but these ones you have to buy at 1500 or 2250. Na hizi ndizo either
the amount you have,
moja inatosha. One is enough. Either kwa sababu
from the one
about 5 years.
Ukiweka hiyo mara moja.
Ukiweka hiyo mara moja. Five years kabla uongeze. But the good thing, system utai-understand when you use it. Sababu nyumba yako hizi fanana na yake na yangu. Naweza kuwa na watoto watatu, mimi nikuwe na 7. Population hiyo ni slightly higher. Sindio? Naweza kuwa kwangu kuna kuwaga na party every 3 months. Wewe, hauna ya mambo kama hiyo. So because the usage is different, ile manhole ya mwisho kabla ingie kwa biodigester inaweza kupea story, inaweza sikia smell earlier than the 5 years. Okay, you call us in order for treatment. The good thing is that iko available na ni affordable. So si kusema ati ni fixed 5 years, hapana. System itaku guide.
Sasa hii inasibia simu.
Unatibia simu.
Unasibia simu. Harafu unasipa simu igine tena ya kutoa.
Ya kutoa imagi. Soapit sasa.
So. Unaeka hadiko. So shimo ya biodigester. Hii inafaa kuwa 4 feet by 6 feet. Ndiyo inaingiaga. Alafu kuenda chini. Kwa hile pipe yenye plumba analeta nayo waste. Ya last manhole. Kutoka hapa, the bottom ya hiyo pipe, nafaa kuchimba 3 feet kuenda chini. Hiyo ndiyo depth yake. Hiyo pipe imeleta, muipime hivyo imekuja kuenda chini ya hiyo pipe, 3 feet.
Kutoka mahali imefika.
Hiyo pipe, 3 feet peke yake.
Hii ndiyo pipe imeleta. Imeleta nini? Imeleta nini? Mahali imetokea. Simuda tiyali imeleta. Kwanzia hapa pipe mahali hiko,
3 feet.
Kujia hiyo. Hii
Exactly.
Kwa
sababu inafaa kuflow pamoja, ni continuous. Itoke kwa manhole, ingia hapa seamless, na itoke huko.
Sasa hii ni kumaanisha, hii unasiba, inaliganisha na?
Na manhole. Exactly. Exactly. Iko hivyo. And then ikitoka hii side ingine, sasa hapa ndio unachimba sock pit. Sasa sock pit, hii ina level. Juu, sasa hii itakuwa deep. Sababu maji itakuwa inakuja hapa yote. After imetoka huko na ni mingi. Unaona hii si storage. Hii inaingisha, ina digest, inatoa. Sasa hapa hii lazima ikuwe kubwa. At least ikuwe 7 feet by 7 by 5. Ingia at least lori moja ya mawe ile kubwa. Juu pia maji ya bafu, ya laundry, ya kitchen, yote itakuja hapa. Na hiyo ndio inakuwa maji mingi. Ya choo si mingi. Maji ya hizo uses zingine ndio mawe.
Then
it's good to know
hapa
kwa kicho
bafu na kitchen.
Hapa kuna hivyo Willy anasema bafu na kitchen ni gray, zinafaa kuja huku kwa hardcore direct. Hapa ni choo peke yake.
Because if you then weke grease tap.
Weke grease tap. Kamano
kako na grease tap. Na grease tap ni kitu naweza jiundia tu.
Ni kama manhole modified kakutega hiyo mafuta na mchele ni natoka kwa sini. Ndi sikuje huku kwa mawe, I block. Inaweza itumia towards 7-8 years when ime block. Ita take time but ita block. So nipoa hiyo manhole ndogo ya kutrap grease. Kuondoa mafuta, mchele, majani chai na grease, mafuta yenye kwa masufuria.
Sinira inatoa na kakutu.
Exactly, yeah. Exactly.
Sasa, nimeiona. Mahali sijaona kwa hizi. Kuna ingine kubwa kushida
hii. Hizi ready made, for now tuko na family use peke yake. Watu 10 kurudi chini. Kama nyumba ni kubwa kushinda hivyo, sisi ni design. Alafu tunakuja kujenga site na concrete.
Nimekuwa nikiuliza maswali kwa sasa.
Sasa Rastas, population ya kanisa ni tofauti. Hivyo tu umesema, for 6 days hakuna mtu church. Sunday wanakuja, ni kanisa denomination gani?
PCA.
Sasa, PCA na jua service ni kama 2 hours, kena sana 2 and a half hours. Out of what 150 utakuta ni only 20% wanajua mahali choo iko sana. It's not very many people. Yeah. So utakuta hiyo population, ukichukua 20 or 30% ya 150, ni watu kama 40 hapo. 30 to 40 people. This system itawaka. Because when they come on Sunday and leave, watarudi tena? Sunday. Fermentation iko sawa. Itawaka. All the way to church, mpaka iko na watu 400-500. It will still work. You wanna take your break, yeah? 6 days before they come back. So it will still work.
Okay.
But for hotels and it's on Amashule. Now that's something.
That's a different set. Sabuao ni watu wako. Continuous. Hotel wako. Nyumba commercial, 3-bedroom, kadha watu wako. But church ni tofauti, ama mosque. Hizo ni tofauti.
Nikuje kwa hini. Usema already,
Yes.
Ni kila kitu kwa sana. Instead, outside here niko na...
Nasikia mzee kwa hatustari.
Outside, niko na show. Pit show. We tried it.
Yes.
So, whatever comes out from the house, inaenda kwa hile
petro. Kwa hile pitch.
Yeah. Ina act kama...
Septic.
Okay.
Can I use this?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Hii dawa, Rastas inaweza tumika job zake, ina clear blocked drainage. Kwa hivyo drainage kama ime block unaweza itumia.
Okay.
Inaondoa smell. Alafu, prevents latrine and septic tank from filling up. Kwa hivyo pia pit latrine, septic tank, haijalishi container, utaisha aje. Bora kitu wapo ni choo, ni sludge, ita deal nayo.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Actually ndio naona imechorwa sink, imechorwa choo, inaweza deal na anything. Bora ni sludge. Same thing with this dawa, hata ukiangalia hizi enzyme, unaona hata wamechora pit latrine.
Yeah.
So unaweza weka kwa pit latrine, kwa septic tank,
Hata kwa kanzo, lagoon, ile treatment ya kanzo, wanaweza tumia hii kutreat.
Okay.
Bora ni sludge. Sasa kitu inakuwa different ni doses. So vya system inatosha na hivi liters, ndio tunajua how many packets you may need.
That's awesome.
How much is this?
This is 950.
950
per packet.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Uko home, eh? Inasaidia sana na ni fast acting.
Sasa.
Sasa iko wapi rasta?
Do you have better this?
Iko na lifespan ya 50 years.
50 years.
Okay. 50 years. Mm. Na weight bearing capacity ya 300 kgs. Mm. Yaani kumaanisha tunaweza simama hivi tuko hapa juu. Na ni kitu tunaweza fanya practically. Saa hizi.
Hizi kwanza kufunika.
Tunaweza panda.
So I think mahali itakwenda kuwekwa. Inafaa hata kama inafunikwa na mchanga kunawekwa kitu kaa ka fence hivi kusuia.
Movement is not necessary. Kitu unaweka tu ni manhole cover. Hapa juu. Hata niwe tu utakuwa na jiko iko hapo. Acha nikuonyeshe picha kadhaa. Okay, kaa sasa hii ni site vile nilikuwa naelezea. Unaona kuna manhole hapa.
Yeah.
Ina collect alafu inaingia inatoka. So hii ndio soak pit. Hizi mamawe. Yeah. Nikishaisha.
Yeah.
So shimo ndio kama hii 4 feet by 6 alafu kuenda chini imeendanisha na drainage ya hii nyumba. Alafu soak pit unaona vile kilikuwa tunasema Acha nione kama niko na picha ya complete. Give me a minute. So, itajengea manhole cover hivi.
Okay.
So, kitu utakuwa unaona ukiangalia from afar. Ni manhole cover peke yake. Ni wewe tu unajua ni nini iko hapo. Hiyo ndio finish yake.
Okay.
18 by 24 mbili za inspection.
Easy. Just
hivyo tu. So hakuna haja ya fence ama isolation. But gari yezi kanyaga juu ni plastic na gari ni mzito.
Okay.
Iko that simple. Hivyo manhole cover mbili za 18 by 24.
Sawa. Si tumetoka Laikipia, tumetoka Bari.
Wow.
Tumetoka Laikipia.
Laikipia ni huko mbele ya Nanyuki.
Kama na
Nyahururu. Okay, huko Marimane hizo masehemu.
Marimane. No. Rumuruti. Yeah, Marimane na Rumuruti. We are both in Laikipia West constituency. Sasa sisi tuko Rumuruti. Ndio ya Rumuruti.
Okay. Interesting.
Kwenye kampuni wameja wanauza mashamba za msitu.
Maguta maguta. Nilikuwa Marara last year November. Tulikuwa na project ya hii sako yenyu kubwa. Tawasako.
Tawasako.
Sisi wafanyia project.
Okay.
So tulikuwa tumeenda kujenga Marara headquarter yao huko.
Okay. Sawa. Nikuwa nikiandika kwa nini kwa WhatsApp. Na hata nikasema sinaona hata ile
nimepewa
direction.
Umekuja
tu nikuja kwa PC.
Okay. Ukaona kanisa ukaja connect. That's good. Karibu sana. So vile mko na pick up ni rahisi tafungua juu hakuna haja mbebechiwa in parts.
Bei.
Bei ni 44,500 pamoja na DOP key. Niko discounted hata kuzia.
Hiyo bei iko juu. Vile niliona kwa social media, ilikuwa umequote 40,000.
Hapana.
Hapana.
Ilikuwa
umequote 40,000. Very true.
Price haijaikuwa.
Very true.
Haijaikuwa lower than that.
Wacha niona kama nitaweza kufungua mahali.
If you find a post yenye imeandika anything less than 44,500, I'll give you 1,000 bob right now. Especially because
mimi huandika hizo update zote. So I know.
Oh, now this is the new setup, sio?
Yes.
Yeah, now you can just we can naweza taka kuona your new office bana. Eh, at least watu waone watu wakitoka mbali.
So Willy, karibu sana. This is our new office.
Okay.
So basically hapa ndio we serve our customers from. When you wanahitaji biodigester, when you wanahitaji dislodge in chemical na enzymes zote wanazipata hapa. I work with a team of several guys. Wengine wameenda kusaidia customer, but here we are with Stella. Stella, say hi. Karibu, karibu.
Okay, okay. Now this is the new office. You know,
yes.
Ulituonyesha the old office. Watu toka mbali.
Man, hapa ndio our current office.
Yeah.
And we thank God, entrepreneurship is a journey.
Yeah.
So the journey continues.
Ah, that's awesome.
Yeah,
that's awesome. Yeah. Oh, looks nice in a graffiti.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Sawa. Any final remarks? Kabla tumalize. Na do you have a website how people can reach you?
Absolutely. Guys can interact with us more online. Our website is www.biotankafrica.co.ke. Unaweza enda hapo, actually ni e-commerce website. So msee anaweza interact na sisi. Aulize swali either through WhatsApp. Na pia anaweza make purchase hapo.
Okay.
Secondly, unaweza check us out on Facebook, Biotank Africa, Biotank Biodigester, Plastic Biodigester KE.
Okay.
Na hizo handles zote unaweza sikipia pale Instagram.
Okay.
The same handles.
Okay. And yes. your office number, how people can...
Yes, you can
just name it, yeah.
Absolutely. You can reach us on 07 7752508 or 0798216606.
Okay, that's yes. Awesome, man. So nimeona, you see, hard work pays, guys, at least these are testament of perseverance and hard work, at least and it's a journey. Entrepreneurship is basically a journey.
Absolutely.
which is hard, but it's fruitful at the end of the tunnel.
Absolutely.
We keep us here.
Yeah.
So you many party a lot of encouragement.
Yeah.
I share, there is so much in common about your story from many other people in entrepreneurship, even in my story. So at least nimeona Vince that umenifunza, and I can see there is light at the end of the tunnel for everyone.
Be encouraged, Willy. What I would say in terms of business ideas, never start a business to look for money. If you start a business to look for money, it's the last thing you'll find. You'll have to close down.
Look for solutions.
Yeah, you have to be a solution provider. And if you're thinking about a solution, think about saving people time and saving them money. If you can save them time and money in whatever you do, then you have a good starting point.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Much appreciated.
Yes.
See you next time, guys.
Thank you very much, Willy.
Okay.